టు మై కిచెన్ వన్ వి బ్రింగ్ మిడిల్ ఈస్టర్న్ కుకింగ్ టు అమెరికా ఇన్ టుడేస్ షో ఐల్ బి మేకింగ్ క్రిస్పీ థిన్ బ్రెడ్ అరబిక్ చీజ్ విత్ గార్లిక్ లీవ్స్ అరబిక్ చీజ్ విత్ బ్లాక్ కోమన్ హబ్బత్ సోడా అండ్ ఐల్ బి మేకింగ్ మ్యారినేటెడ్ చీజ్ అండ్ మ్యారినేటెడ్ ఆలివ్స్ We'll start off by making the dough for the crispy thin bread. For this recipe, I need 2.5 teaspoons dry yeast, equivalent to 1 envelope dry yeast. We'll add 1/2 cup warm water. That should be good. We'll let it sit for 5 minutes. Add 6.5 cups bread flour to the yeast mixture. Level the cup. One tablespoon of salt, I'm using kosher salt, and 1 tablespoon of black cumin, which is habbat soda. We'll mix everything together. To form a smooth dough. Everything is nicely mixed together. We'll change the mixing attachment to the dough attachment to finish kneading the dough. Dough is ready. It's beautiful, so nice and smooth. What I would do is I will brush my glass bowl with some olive oil. And form the dough into a smooth ball. Place it in the bowl. Turn to coat all surfaces with olive oil. Brush the lid with some olive oil and cover it with a kitchen towel. Let it sit for about 1 to 1.5 hours or until it doubled in size. The dough has been sitting for about 1.5 hours to rise. And look how beautiful, how doubled in size. Now I will divide the dough into maybe a size of a small apple. I will cut out a piece, dip it in some flour, and set it on a parchment paper. Depending on how big your loaves you want them to be, many people might make their crispy bread real large and then they fold it in half or they fold it into 4/4. I like to make them individual sizes, so I don't make them fully large. About maybe 10 to 12 inches in diameter, that's what I like to make my crispy bread. Dip in flour, set them on the parchment paper. This kind of bread will go nicely with the cheese that we made and with the other marinated cheese and marinated olives. It will be great items for breakfast or brunch. kitchen towel and we'll let them rest for about 20 to 30 minutes. I have my barbecue heated to 500 degrees and I have a pizza sun inside the barbecue that's very, very hot. So it's ready for us to go. And the dough, it's been sitting resting for about 30 minutes. I think we are ready to make our crispy thin bread. I will take a piece at a time. Sprinkle my work surface with some flour. Try to stretch it as much as you can with a regular rolling pin. As thin as possible. And then using a much thinner rolling pin, about 2 inches in diameter, this will help stretch and thin out all the sides. Sprinkle with some flour. So all what you have to do is you take make it look as good as possible. And let me show you how thin this is. You can see through it. Now, what I would do is with the aid of my rolling pin, I will transfer this dough onto the baking stone. And we'll let it cook for about 2 to 3 minutes on each side. We'll flip it to the other side. Look how beautiful it looks. Okay, the bread is ready. We'll put it in our basket. We don't want to cover it because we want to make it crispy. And now we are ready to place the other loaf of bread onto the baking stone. Cook it for 2 to 3 minutes on each side. So beautiful. Look at these bubbles. Look how beautiful. Spotted brown spots. Now I'm ready to make the Arabic cheese with the garlic leaves. For this recipe, I need 2 gallons of regular milk. You want to make sure you use a large pot to hold both gallons together. We'll place it on high heat. We want to bring the temperature of the milk up to 105 degrees. In the meantime, I have 1/2 tablet of rennet that I'm gonna dissolve in 1/2 cup of water. You wanna make sure you read the direction for what kind of rennet tablets you are using. Sometimes it could say rennet junket. You might need to use about 5 times more of the tablets. If you're using 1/2, you need to use 2.5 then. This can that I'm using today is very strong, so you need to make sure to read the direction, and that will tell you how many tablets you can use per gallon or per 2 gallons. So you just want to be careful, read the instruction on the tablet packets. When using a thermometer, the temperature should reach 105 degrees. and you see the temperature is at 105 degrees, if you don't have a thermometer, just dip your finger in the milk, and when it's nice and warm and you can handle it, to keep your finger there for 10 seconds, that means it's warm enough. Now, we will add the mixture of water and the rennet tablet to our mixture. And stir. Wait for about 15 to 20 minutes for the milk to curdle. Now the milk mixture has been sitting for about 20 minutes. The milk curdled already. Do you see how nice and thick? It looks thicker than yogurt, if that's what you're looking for. At this stage, I will add the garlic leaves. I will just chop them inside the pot. This will give our cheese a very unique flavor, the sharpness from the leaves, and also it's gonna give it nice color. Usually, whenever I'm ready to make some cheese, I will plant a few cloves of garlic in a small pot. In about 2 to 3 days, the leaves will come out, and that's what I use to make the cheese. Some specialty stores might sell the garlic leaves, especially summertime. But you can always use chives or mint, whatever herbs you like to use actually. Garlic leaves is really a traditional herbs to use for this kind of cheese. A couple more here that I'll add, and then mix everything nicely together. You wanna make sure all these leaves are gonna incorporate into the cheese mixture. I have this container, or this actually mold that I bought from a place where they sell only stuff to make cheese. So this is like a plastic container. It has holes all around the sides and the bottom. And it's a nice mold. It's gonna give you a nice looking cheese mold. And it's gonna help all the whey to drain from it. And I will line this with two layers of cheesecloth fabric, and here I have a colander that I'm gonna set it on top for the whey to drain, or the liquid to drain from the cheese mixture. So now what I would do is I will ladle this cheese mixture into the cheesecloth, letting all the whey to drain through the holes of that mold. Look how beautiful the milk curdles. Looks so, so nice. This is very, very good cheese. It's so delicious. Lift the corners up a little bit. That will help more liquid to drain from the cheese. Just lift it up a little bit. And then set it down and add more to it. We'll bring all these four corners together. This will help lifting it up like that, will help the whey to come out, or to drain out. I mean the liquid. That's what's called, this liquid that's draining from the cheese, it's called the whey. I remember when my mom used to make cheese, she will reserve all this whey, and this is what she used to make bread, to use it as a liquid to make a dough. I guess it's very nice. Okay, and then with the mold, it came this device that's gonna go exactly on top of this. I'm gonna press down as hard as we can to squeeze all the liquid out. See how much liquid is coming down? Try to find a very heavy object that's gonna go on top. This is very, very heavy. It's about 10 pounds. And press on it and let it sit for about 1 hour for the liquid to drain. I have the wheat sitting on top of the cheese for about 1.5 hours, and there is so much wheat that drained out still from the cheese. So I think it should not be that much wheat left in there. So what I would do now is I will take the mold with the mold, the top mold on top, place it in here, and this is gonna go in the fridge for about 6 to 8 hours. Now I'll be making another kind of Arabic cheese. It's gonna be with black cumin, habbat soda. It's gonna be much more creamier this time because I'm using regular milk and half and half. So for this recipe, I need 1 gallon of regular milk. And 2 quarts of half and half. We'll place it on high heat. We will try to get the temperature up all the way to 105 degrees. For this recipe, while we are waiting for the milk to reach 105 degrees, I will get the lemon juice ready. I will need 1/2 cup of freshly squeezed lemon juice for this recipe. Just perfect. That's 1/2 cup. And now we'll check the milk temperature. We want to make sure it's at 105 degrees, and it is exactly at 105 degrees. Now I will add the lemon juice to the milk. We'll give it a quick stir. We'll wait for the milk to curdle for about 10 to 15 minutes. The milk curdles already. Now to this, I will add about 2 tablespoons of black cumin, habbat soda, to the mixture. You can add caraway seeds, you can add fennel seeds, you can add whatever seeds you like, just to add some flavor to the cheese. And we will ladle the curdled cheese into the cheesecloth that's lined inside another mold that I have. And it's sitting into a pan for all the liquid to drain out from the cheese. This looks so, so good. This is gonna be much creamier cheese because we used half and half, and it's gonna be great. We'll lift all sides together. This will help more wheat to drain, more liquid to drain out. And then we'll keep ladling the cheese mixture into the cheesecloth. We'll fold all the sides of the cheesecloth over the cheese. And then, having this great device that came with the mold, look how beautiful. It fits right into the mold. Squeeze as much liquid as possible. See, there's still a lot coming. We're gonna press as much pressure as we can. Looks good. And then place a real heavy object on top and let it sit for about 1 hour. Now I'm ready to make the marinated olives. For this recipe, I need 2 pounds of green olives, pitted green olive with the pits on them. And I need 1 tablespoon of curry powder. I need 1/2 cup of vinegar, 2 cups of lemon juice, and few cloves, 3 to 4 cloves of garlic. So what I would do is, I will roughly chop the garlic. We'll go in there. And now we will squeeze 2 lemon juice, 2 to 3, depending on how much juice there is in them. We need 2 cups of lemon juice. Okay, that's good. And this one going here. And we need to slice 2 lemons. Thinly slice them. That's gonna go in between the olives. Great. So now we are ready to marinate the olives. So what I would do is, I will add 1 tablespoon of curry powder into the jar, 1/2 cup of vinegar, 2 cups of freshly squeezed lemon juice, and 1 cup of extra virgin olive oil. Then I will add some of the olives in there. I have 2 pounds of green olives. Add some slices of lemon. This is an amazing, amazing way to eat olives. They'll be nice and marinated and they will be so, so good. Add some more garlic in between. And keep layering the olives with the lemon slice. temperature for about 2 to 3 days until we are ready to use it. Now we are ready to make the marinated cheese. For this recipe, I need some cumin, some fennel seeds, some peppercorn, whole peppercorn, and some sliced garlic. And I made some cheese yesterday. That's just plain, I didn't add anything to it. Cut it into cubes. For this recipe, I also need a peel of a lemon. That I will peel. This looks good. Now I have a glass jar ready. I will add all the peel in there. 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds goes in there. 1 teaspoon of fennel seeds goes in there. 1 tablespoon of mixed peppercorns, whole, goes in there. 4 cloves sliced garlic. 1/2 cup of extra virgin olive oil to start with. And then 1/2 cup of freshly squeezed lemon juice. That goes in the mixture also. I'll put the lid on and shake everything together. And now I'll add the cheese cubes that I cut into the mixture. This is great, great way to serve cheese. It's so flavorful. It's gonna be spicy, and the lemon juice and the lemon peel, it's gonna give it beautiful, beautiful smell and flavor. Okay, we'll add some more extra virgin olive oil to it. We don't wanna fill the whole thing with olive oil, that should be good. Put the lid back on, and then we'll try to shake it. Wanna make sure everything is nicely mixed and coated with all the mixture. And this will sit in the fridge for about 3 days, and we need to shake it occasionally as we go. I have some fresh mint from my garden that I will cut to serve with the cheese and the bread. So I will just go ahead and get a few sprigs of fresh mint. Smells so, so good. Smells amazing. And you know how well mint goes with the cheese and the olives and the bread. So that should be good. Look how beautiful. Real nice, smells amazing. Look how beautiful my bread is. Now they are all nice and dry and they are crispy. So you just place them on top of each other, stack them nicely like this, and you'll be ready to use them whenever you want. And this is a great, great way to preserve the bread when it's dry like this. Before, I remember with my grandparents, I asked my grandma, I told her, why are you making the bread so crispy and then you have to spray it with water to make it soft again? This was like always something that, you know, I was amazed by. So she told me, you know, because before they didn't have refrigerators and they didn't have a way to store the bread. So having it crispy like this, it will last for a very long time. You could store it in air, in dry, dark place for up to 2 to 3 months. And now the cheese has been sitting in the fridge for about 6 to 8 hours. So what I would do is I will remove the top part from the mold. Are ready to unmold the other cheese, the black cumin cheese. We'll do the same thing again. We will remove it and place it in here. I made garlic leaves, Arabic cheese, and black cumin, Arabic cheese, marinated cheese, and marinated olives. Thank you so much for coming to my kitchen and enjoy Middle Eastern cooking. We hope to see you next time with more exotic dishes from the Middle East.